All right, we have three zone valves here. One of them, she'd been leaking for a while and messed up the motor, and I can't unscrew it. So I gotta drain down. So I got a valve here. I'm gonna pop this bad boy open. Get rid of all the pressure that's here. I tried getting that one out, but I got this one out, but not that one. So I'm gonna drain down the boiler, well, the piping here. These are closed, and I have the valve shut off over there. So I have the manual open valve. Well, not really doing anything, but these are closed with resistance. So make sure none of the other ones are leaking. No, they're okay. But that's pretty jacked up. So we're almost done draining down. I'm going to get creative here with the angle grinder. I'm gonna cut. You know, I'm gonna try to cut right there, maybe pop this bad boy out. Now that one is not gonna come out, but I figured if I could at least loosen up the others, if it's airlocked. Oh, I guess it really doesn't matter, right? All right, I'll let the water get out of here. Now I am going to, you know what? Thinking about brazing it out. I mean, sweating it out, banging that up. But I'm gonna probably hit the fresh air intake. So let's just wait for this thing to finish draining. Screw that. The hell? I hope my tank's not empty. Clean that off with the emery paper. Yeah, no one deburred the pipe there. Very carefully. I deburred the pipe. Alright, here's the new Honeywell zone valve. I am not gonna mess with that manual open setting right there. I'm gonna keep it where it is. And we're gonna sweat in this new valve head with a little bit of heat. Not too much heat, just a little bit of heat. So if you're gonna use a big, torch head or map gas, you risk burning out the insides of the zone valve, the little rubber parts and the gaskets, and then you'll be screwed. So word of advice shall suffice. I think the tip on my turbo torch is shot, so I'm not gonna really mess with sweating off what I cut off on the top of the old zone valve, so I have enough play there. I should cut myself open. Let's clean the, flux it up. Deburr it, solder it up. Body and the piping, of course. All right, before I go all crazy wiring it, let's fill it with some water. I'm just taking water from the tankless flush valve. Just a little bit of pressure, not too much. So make sure I have no leaks. Okay, that's good. Okay. That should be all right for now. Let's open up. Let's power on. And let's open up our valves and purge any air out. Now, many of you may be asking, why didn't I just rewire it to the wire nuts there? Well, there's a good answer for that. I own it. And as clean as this looks, considering what it is, I'd rather just do that. Whew. Okay, let's turn power on and check for circulation.